thank you. So I will try to go through this very quickly because I've already mentioned the term key population-led health services in my previous presentation. But here, just to get into a little bit more detail, because all three presenters have been talking about key population or community-led HIV testing and self-testing. I may want to go a bit further part of and beyond what we can use these key population-led health services to enhance services beyond HIV testing. This is the term that we formed in Thailand 2 years ago. We started with community-led health services, but it seems people did not recognize well when we use the term community-led, because it was more like African setting where you like go knock door to door asking people to do HIV testing, something like that. But what we did is it's not geographic community, but it's more of the population-based community here. So the concept of doing this is we as healthcare providers realize that we are not the best person to be the one who design the service. So we really work seriously with the key populations themselves in order to get them to design the best service that could address not only HIV but other health concerns of priority within their own communities. And then it's not the work that we can do with or by the community themselves. It is a true partnership and a very close partnership between community-based organization and public health sectors. And all the services that the communities design, that it could be the roles that they can play by themselves, or the HIV-related health services, are built according to the national guidelines. And this brings us to the explanation of why do we need these key population-led or community-led health services. I would not talk much about the accessibility and acceptability, because we have heard about that for many times now. But it's also the availability component of service set by the key populations themselves, in a way that in a conventional setting, you know, in a facility-based setting, where we may not be able to do so, to make services that key populations think are relevant to themselves be available in a facility-based or conventional setting. What does this mean? This means that, for example, for transgender women, you may not be able to easily integrate a hormone service delivery into a BCT clinics or PICT clinics, for sex workers, you may not be able to integrate the legal consultation into your BCT clinic. But having a KP-led model means that you have the key populations of design what should be the component, a combination of services provided to bring them into sexual health services, which include HIV services as well. So here is where we are talking about getting the work that we do with key population communities to what is truly KP-led health services. Having the community-based testing is different from having community-led service or testing, because you know when we work with the community, having them being the one who reach and recruit people into the test into HIV testing service, but we have to wait for the facility and staff to be available to go out to do mobile testing or to provide HIV testing. It may not always be feasible. So tailor certain HIV-related services to KPLA providers could be the way to answer that question. And these services can include HIV testing, in which you have been talking about. For us in Thailand, lay providers are not only do HIV screening, they are also performing HIV confirmation as well. So that means that HIV diagnosis, whether that's HIV negative or HIV positive diagnosis, can be made on even in the same hour by lay providers to their clients. And then we add the PrEP and PEP component into that service setting. And here, with the 2 years or more of these key population-led health services implementation, we have seen that by having lab providers being able to provide HIV testing by themselves and also provide PrEP and PEP as well as do ART dispensing for those clients who are referred out from the hospital because they are already stable on ART. We have been able to identify people with extremely high HIV prevalence and incidence, which I will show you in the next slide. We have also been able to serve people living with HIV on stable ART and reduce the burden of the hospital. So it's a win-win situation between the public health facilities and the community-based organization. And that we have been able to provide PrEP, as I mentioned to you, and then contribute to more than half of PrEP access in the country right now. The prevalence that we have identified so far using this key population-led model is around 18% among MSM and 9% among transgender women, which is higher than the prevalence among MSM and transgender women at the national level. And we have been successfully linked more than 80% of them into ART care. And you can see that these populations are having a really high HIV incidence of as high as 12% per year among male sex workers in Pattaya. So it has been demonstrated very clearly that these are populations who are the prime target for PrEP service. So this is just to summarize that if you look at the impact of HIV testing and HIV diagnosis and PrEP at the national level, by having these key population-led health services implemented in only four key strategic provinces, the lay providers contributed to 42% of overall testing among MSM and transgender women. Or you can look at it in another way, that if we do not have key population lay provider testing, we can only achieve half of HIV testing that we have had over the past year. We have also diagnosed 35% of new HIV diagnosis within the past year as well. And more importantly is that the median CD4 count of those who were diagnosed with HIV through KPLA providers is much higher than those diagnosed within the hospital. The median CD4 count is around 370 compared to only 170 among those who diagnosed in the hospital. So what we are doing earlier HIV diagnosis, which surely contribute to reduction of HIV transmission. And lastly, right now we are in the stage of trying to make this model sustainable in the country. So in the past, we have been using Global Fund money in order to do this KP-led or KP-based, KP community-based health services. Even when we demonstrated the impact of the proportion of HIV testing and treatment, the question would be, what's the standard of these KP-led providers? Do they providing these services at the national standard? And so over the past year, we have set up a national training and certification systems with the use of USAID community partnership funding in order to get these services provided by their providers considered as meeting the national standard and also to receive accreditation at the national level, so that will bring key population lay providers to the stage that they can get direct government funding to the CBO themselves, rather than what has been the funding mechanism so far, that funding flows from government to the hospitals, and then it's stuck inside the hospital, couldn't go out from the hospital to the community-based organization, and we always have to wait for funding from outside to come to sustain these CBOs, which would not be a sustainable way to go. So this is just the part that I have to share for this panel. Thank you.